Hello, Coach Dad here, and we are here to make a corrections video from one of my previous videos, the top 12 chess principles. And even as chess players, as we're looking at the board and we're trying to scan the board, we are trying to find out what kind of mistakes our opponents are trying to make, and even find out what kind of mistakes we ourselves have made and learned from them. And during the time when I made the top 12 chess principles video, there were a couple of mistakes that kind of just flew straight over my head, where black can have a great counter towards some of these chess principles that I've mentioned throughout the video. And let's talk about this example right here. In this specific example, what I said previously was that white was trying to find a double attack, and white would be able to play knight to e5. Therefore, this knight would attack both of these rooks. It looks good on paper. It looks great on this board at this moment, saying, hey, I have this knight. I'm able to attack both of these rooks at the same time. But what black can do is black can create a counter attack by forcing a check onto white's king at b1. And what happens here is that white has to respond back to this danger, to this attack, because white cannot leave its king in check. So therefore, white will probably do something like this and move to c1. And therefore, black has a way to respond to get this rook out of danger. And what's another great move that black can make is moving this piece right here, therefore creating a counter double attack, creating a skewer through both of these pieces right here. So even though if white decides to move this knight away right here, black can take this piece and attack the bishop. Or in this example, even though if you decide to come here and attack this rook, I can even take away this knight right here. So it's a lose-lose for white, and I do admit that the example that I've made previously was not a very good example on the board. But that's such a great thing about the YouTube community, is that they are able to use their skills and find these kind of mistakes and really bring it out into the light. And I encourage you to, even though if you think you find something on paper saying, hey, that's a great move, this is a great double attack, look at all the counters that black can make in this situation. Look at all the possible scenarios that black can attack in this particular move. In the previous top 12 chess principles video, I was talking about in this example of simplifying when ahead. Of course, when you are ahead in pieces, you want to try take away and trade off pieces from your opponent so that you can make the board easier to see. So therefore, if you are ahead, you want to make sure that your opponents have less pieces to fight with and less pieces to have a chance to have a comeback with. But in this example, this is a really perfect example of using your eyes to find the perfect move. What white can do to just simply end this game, and we're talking about simply ending this game, is moving rook to d8 right here, and therefore creating a checkmate. The king, the black king, has nowhere to move. Therefore, the game is over. There's no need for all the unnecessary trading like I was talking about last time, where I would try to go here and rook comes over here, and next thing you know, you can even try to do something like this, rook blocks, and you take that. So you created more confusion like that, but in actuality, what we could have done to prevent all of this commotion right here was simply move rook down to d8, and the game is over. In this specific example, I was talking about taking initiative, moving your pieces towards the middle so that they can have better opportunities to attack. As someone explained to me and mentioned to me in the comments, what they said was, hey, Coach Dad, if you move both your pieces right here in this example, and of course white hasn't even moved their pieces yet, couldn't white just play c3 in order to create a double attack on two of your minor pieces? this is a perfect example of finding the double attack. And I love this example that was pointed out to me. What happens is if I decide to come here and move my both of minor pieces in this position, yes, white can play c3 in order to trade off a single pawn for one of my minor pieces right here. Even though if I do attempt to try to take it, white would be able to take my bishop, and I would even have to waste my move to retreat back. It's just a very simple example. When I was creating this example, white hasn't even moved a single piece yet. But I really wanted to teach people that you could try and move your pieces to try to come and attack the middle, be able to take the initiative. Don't play very passive moves where you're just keeping both your bishops back here, barely attacking white, or even your knight back here and things like that. So you want to make sure your knights have opportunities to attack the center squares, be able to move forward and continue its advance towards the white's king. I would like to take the time to thank all the overwhelming support from my subscribers, YouTubers, viewers. Look, the support has been very overwhelming in the past 3 years. I never knew that this channel would blow up like this. As we move on and move forward with future videos, I can't wait to produce more videos for you guys in the future. So if you like what you see, please remember to hit the subscribe button down below. Remember to hit the bell icon for any notifications for future videos. And remember, good luck on your chess. Thank you very much for joining class today. Can't wait to see you in the future. Thank you.